Jacked up, crazy, act up, messed up. If that's some of your same spirit that you got, it's just coming out through them. Spirits transfer, if y'all didn't know. They transfer. So if you don't rebuke that spirit, get in your kids. They crazy, they bad. No, you bad too. I ain't leaving you out. You bad too.
Amen.
And he was a priest, and one day he went to the temple, and when he got there, Hannah was there, and he thought Hannah was drunk. She was not drunk. He came back later and apologized to her and let her know she was praying in the spirit because she was desired a child.
Yes.
She was barren. And he went back and he apologized to her and he prayed with her. He said, this time, sometime in the year, you are going to have a son. And she did. She named that son Samuel. And Samuel was raised up and he was taught by Eli. It's amazing how people can teach somebody else but you can't tell your kids that. You don't believe it? Go read it. It's Samuel. And he taught Samuel. Raised him up. And when Samuel was a little boy, he said, Samuel was there at the temple and Samuel had went to sleep. I'm trying to go fast. And he went to sleep and he told him, he said, you called me. Yeah. Eli said, no, son, I didn't call you. Go back and lay down. Right. Lay down again. The Lord said, Samuel. He went, got up. He said, Eli, you called me. He said, no, son, I didn't call you. Went back again, and Eli said, if he calls you again, you answer saying, here I am, Lord. How many answer the call, here I am, Lord? If he wake you up, somebody say, get up, here I am, Lord. I'm ready, Lord. Whatever it is, whatever you got before me, I'm ready to take it, Lord. So, Eli raised him. You know, sometimes we can have in-laws and, children raised up in the same church and everything, and they can be all grouped together. It's something about some people, kids, they just ain't gonna do right. And then, come along in that same scenario. He was teaching Samuel, but he wasn't teaching his kids nothing. Teaching Samuel, but you wasn't teaching your kids nothing. But guess what? They went to battle. Eli's home went to battle. And both of them got killed. Yeah. And then when they came back and they told Eli, he was hurt and he fell back and broke his neck.
Yes.
The word Samuel told him, that God said, you know your son. You need to get on your son. It's in there. It's in there. He said, you need to get on your son. Samuel told him. This is the same little boy that you have raised up in the church that you didn't tell. You got on him, but you let yours out. Money. If you can't take orders, you don't need to be in this place. Everybody doing unseemly things in church. That's why the Bible tells us the judgment ain't gonna begin at the house of God. They gonna start here first. You ain't got to worry about judging somebody. It's gonna begin here first. So when he found out that they were showing out, he took them out. You get down. You coming down. You're not gonna be over nobody if you can't walk right. That's what I'm saying. He just doing what his father does. I don't want to do everything that my father did. I don't want to know my father's pain. I want to live right so God can use me. He called me. He said, I called the young because they were strong. So why in the world I want to go live out of my father? All my father did, I don't want to know. All I did, I definitely don't want nobody to know. Yeah.
us in this language, to bring up all sides of the church. God, I want to come on the watch here so you make your decision. Where you place your membership. Pour down every message. Goodness and love you. One of the soul saving, soul searching messages. You helped us on today, goodness and love you. You helped us. We appreciate you. Going this way, God gives it to you. Amen. No one has come, but there is still room. We're going to hear from her father at this time.